Well, I don't know about you guys, but I've got a saw blade here, and let's not let it go to waste. Let's make a knife. I'm going to be completely honest with you guys. I'm not a knife maker. I'm probably going to do some things wrong, but I'm more of a hobbyist than anything. I like to mess around with things that I can find. If I can find something that's been junk and I can turn it into something useful, I like to do it. So I'll go ahead and show you a couple of knives that I've made in the past. I've only made three, but you can see the progression of how I've improved. The one thing that stays consistent with all of them is they're sharp. So this is my first knife I've made. You've seen this in my first knife video that I made. I'll put the video to this in the link, but I'll be honest with you, it's a pretty junky video. I was working off an old camera, but if you want to see how I did this one, you can go and check that out video if you want to. This knife, it was an attempt at a convex grind, which was kind of a fail. I had never owned a convex grind up until this, and then my Jeff White, but I didn't even know how to sharpen one at the time, so I ended up kind of putting it on a stone to give it some sharpness. But here, I'll give you a quick close-up of it. It's got, there we go, focus in there. Come on. It's got walnut handles, brass pins. I made it out of an old file. And there's the convex grind on it. It's not perfect, but it is pretty sharp. I'll go ahead and show you that. It will remove some hairs. So, not too bad. Decent knife. I'll show you my next one. The second knife I made, I wanted to do a hidden tang. So I had a piece of cherry that my neighbor had given me, and I gave it a go. But the first attempt was a fail. I tried drilling holes down inside to make it all neat and flush. So when I stuck my blade inside, it would be, you wouldn't even be able to see a seam all the way around it. But when I looked on the inside, to where the knife, basically ended and then the handle began, there was always a gap. I couldn't get it perfectly square, and I didn't like it. This one, I made out of a handle too, out of a file as well. I'll give you a close up of this one. I tried a few things new on this one. I went for a saber grind, and I used cherry wood. But as you could see, my second attempt at the handle. You didn't see this in the beginning, this seam, when I glued it all together, but now you do see it, unfortunately. But, I mean, I'm still learning, so. But it's a real chunky handle, but it fits in my hand real nice, and it's good for power cutting and everything. And this one as well is pretty sharp. I'll give you a look. This one as well, will shave hairs quite easily. So, not the prettiest knife on the planet, but it's very functional and it holds an edge pretty well. And of course, there's my pretty much favorite knife that I own. It's my my neck knife that I made. This little guy was made out of an old saw blade, like the next one. And I figured this little guy needed a brother to go with it. This guy is quite sharp as well. I mean, this guy will shave hairs no problem. He'll take hairs off, and it's got a pretty good edge retention also. The one thing I will say about it though is when I learned a lot about heat treating on this one. I hardened it. I got it hardened up to a 62 on a Rockwell. I tested at work, but I didn't temper it properly. So actually, the first time I used it, I broke the tip off. I was trying to do a bow drill set with it. I was shooting a video with it. I broke the tip off of it. I lost my mind and scrapped the video. So I ended up repairing the knife. I made it a little bit shorter. I grinded down. I filed it down, and I was able to keep the knife usable. And then I took off removed the handles, rehandled it, and then actually shot the video for this after that. So yeah. So that's that. I'll give you a close-up of this guy too. With this knife, it was also my first attempt at making a sheath. I've never done any leather work before, so I made this guy to hold my neck knife, and here it is. I put on oak handles, brass pins, same brass pins I'm going to put on the other one. But I'm thinking about on the new one, we'll take some quarter inch. These are quarter inch, and I figure we'll do a 16th or 1/8 brass pins, and we'll put two on the front end of it just to change it up a little bit. But so there's that. It's a good little knife. I absolutely love this thing. It's sharp like crazy, holds an edge real well, and I'm going to try to follow the same recipe with this one as we are going to do with the new one, and hopefully we can make this guy a big brother. So, I got a half saw blade here. I've drawn out my template on here. Basically what I've done is I've gone with the Jeff White bush knife shape. I really like the shape of the knife. I really like the, it's very durable. It's thick and strong. The only thing I didn't like was the handle I found was too thin at the front, two fingers for my hand. So what I did is I went ahead and I made the handle a little bit wider, a little bit chunkier. So at least at this end, it may be a little bit bigger. If you can see here, at this end, it's going to be a little bit bigger and closer to the same size. I may have to bring this down a little bit once we handle it, but it should be pretty good. Now, I'm not sure if I'm going to do three dots or two dots or put a lanyard loop inside. I have no idea what I'm going to do with this part yet. This is just a design to get an idea of what I think the knife's going to look like. I will go with this shape of the handle though, with the thing, and we're going to use oak like we did on the neck knife. So the tools we'll be using today is a cutting disc, a clamp. We'll obviously be using our saw blade, just a grinder, and we're going to put a cutting disc on it and a file. So all that together, we'll get this first step here done. So let's start cutting. All right, so here's our progress so far. Made a little boo-boo and I gave it a little nick there, but that'll be hidden, no problem. I'm still gonna bring this in just a tiny bit anyway, so that's okay. The first knife I made, the first one I showed you in the video, I did that one completely with just one of these. From beginning to end, was all file. It took forever. It's, it was some kind of a macho thing I heard on a blade forum that, you know, your first knife you should always make with only you should make with a file so you can appreciate the process. Yeah, that's bullshit. It takes way too long. Use a grinder. Our blank, very roughed out, but we're gonna keep on going. We're gonna go slap this into the vise, and we'll rough it all. We'll get all this rough bits off of here, make it nice, that nice for the hand. And first, I like to tighten up my vise, and then I like to use just a plain file to start shaping it out. First, try to attack any kind of lumps or high points in the blade, and then once I got that, I'll start rounding the corners. So I'm gonna keep on going on this, and I'll come back a little bit later once it's all done. So here's our blank. We're all cut out. It's looking pretty good, I think. I'll bring it in a little closer, actually, give you a better look. You'll see the ends nice and rounded. Pretty smooth all the way around. Handle fits. We got a decent curve in here. It fits my hand quite nicely already. And once we have our scales put on there, it's going to be pretty nice. So that's our shape. A knife this big, you would normally probably not use steel this thin for, but this is just a practice for me. It still may make a pretty good knife, but I do want to get some more practice in and kind of hone my skills before I start spending money on good steel for knife blanks. Although you can make decent knives out of saw blades, but yeah, anyway, this is practice. I want to hone my skills a little better before I start buying, mosaic pins and all that stuff to make my knives really nice. It'll cost a lot of money to buy those things, and I don't want to have to buy them and mess them up, if you know what I mean. Well, all right, guys. So I'm pretty pleased with what we wound up with here. I think that we're going to call that quits for today. But in the upcoming video, we're going to pop our holes in here. I still got to decide if I can get my hands on a little tube so we can put a lanyard hole in here. But I'm not sure if that'll work out. I've had a hard time finding those in our local stores around here. But anyway, if not, I'll put that with a big pin and we'll get two small pins for down the bottom. We'll be working on the bevel, and we're going to use this jig that I made. And I'll give you basically an idea of how to make it and why I like it and what it's used for and so on. But we'll get into that in the next video. So just want to give you guys a quick thanks a lot for watching. And I've picked up quite a few subscribers in the last couple of months. I don't have all your names written down right now, but I've sent you messages saying thank you, and I absolutely mean it. You guys are awesome. And I hope you like the videos. I hope you like this video. I've got a whole bunch more on the way for you guys. So you guys take care. Like, share, and subscribe. And I'll see you again soon, man. Take it easy.